What happens is, no, that when a client who's afraid of arrest, okay, at that time comes to you because he apprehends either an FIR is filed or will be filed, okay. Now the client hasn't given you the mandate. They have come to speak to you, and in that process, you have to convince the client to give you the work, right? And you will also have to then provide some part of the solution. And then once they give you the work, you'll have to do the work and raise the bill, right? Now at this stage, you have to make a number of decisions. As an independent lawyer, or even as a junior, you will need to make a few decisions around how do I advise the client? Which remedy should I say? Remember, I told you staying away from the jurisdiction, 482 bail, anticipatory bail. You'll have to decide all of that for that which one is best for the client right now and why? Okay, because they will ask you, and if you sound confused that no, it's fine, it's all okay, it'll not work. Then the drafting part is there. You remember the 40-page example versus a 10-page example. Then the filing part is there. Filing has to be proper. Okay, because one filing error and you have to correct it, you may lose time and somebody else may spend that time in jail. Okay, then argument stage. If your argument doesn't happen properly, your drafting is good, but the relief is not there for the client. Okay, if sometimes you do everything right, sometimes you may mess up, sometimes you may do everything right. You do everything right. After that, also judge gives you an adverse order. Okay. Then you want to go to appeal or revision, or against the revision, you want to go to to Supreme Court for an SLP. Okay. Then SLP means special leave petition. Okay. That's what happened in Arnab Goswami's case, right? So now if you this whole aspect you need to know. Why? Because one judgment that's adverse to your client, you should be able to take the next action. Now I have a question for you, okay? These are how many stages you count number of bullets? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 hyphens. If you do 3 things correctly, but not 6, what's going to be the cost of it? Right? There will be 2 lawyers. Imagine 3 things you have spent hours and year and days and months learning with a senior, but all 6 you don't know, versus a lawyer who knows all 6. Who's going to get the work and by how much? The one who knows all 6 will be the one who will get the results, right? But somebody who knows only 3 will get to say what? What will the person who knows only 3 say? He'll not get all the results and he will complain. Judge was bad. I don't know what to do. Clients don't pay. I work so hard, but I don't get what I want, right? So the point is that to be able to get results for your clients, and the whole point is going to be that you have a good career if you can get your clients' results. That means all 6 is in your on your responsibility. 3 out of 6 is not good. Even 5 out of 6 is not going to be good enough. And you might be surprised that, you know, somebody who knows 1 out of 6 and somebody who knows 3 or 4 out of 6, there won't be much difference. Okay. But somebody who knows 6 out of 6 will be a superstar, will be getting lots of clients, lots of success, lots of recognition.